the agenda. Anyone have anything on the agenda? On the agenda? You don't have it on the agenda. You're after the agenda. Okay. Nobody on the agenda? We will close this and comments on the agenda. Your communications, Madam Clerk? And we have a lot of Hochhausers here. And they're all in full uniform. Mom's not uniform. Where is it? Can I have the uniform? We made him come back dressed, because he came by himself last week.
Yes.
And we said, bring the crew and be in uniform.
Yeah.
When was your service? I forget.
January 17th.
January 17th, the township manager and myself had the privilege of attending the Board of Honor for Leo at the Elks. And it was very, very nice and very well done. And I mentioned the time that I was a Boy Scout, but I only made, what's the first row?
You said second class.
I made it, what's the second one?
Tenderfoot is the second.
Tenderfoot, what's the one before that?
Scout.
What's the one after that?
Second class.
I think I might have made the second class, I'm not sure. But there was some with arrows and guns that didn't work out too well. I think I told you that, I shot an arrow and, you know, 6 inches either way. So I decided that was it, I hung everything up. So anyway, we have the privilege, we asked Leo and the family to come out today. And before I read the proclamation, I want to thank Hal for resurrecting our local Boy Scout troop. For many, many years, and now it's really thriving. How many members?
We have about 22 Cub Scouts, and I think it's 18 Boy Scouts.
That's very good. That's very nice. Before I do this, I want to add one thing. You get a chance to say something after I read this.
It's okay.
So it's a proclamation from Township Council. Whereas the Boy Scouts of America has grown to be a vital force of development of our youth through its many programs, which encourage the ability of its members to do things for themselves and others. And whereas Leo Hochhauser, a longtime resident of Weehawken, joined the Cub Scout Pact 18 in 2005, sponsored by the United Synagogue of Hoboken, and in 2009 transferred as a charter member to Weehawken Troop 223. And that's the truth that you started the time of prayer. Whereas as a senior leader, Leo led the troops' first meetings and ceremonies, and also led numerous events such as Memorial Day parades, Flag Day ceremonies, and now participates in the troop as an assistant scoutmaster. And whereas Leo has earned the highest Boy Scout award of Eagle Scout, particularly through his Eagle Project, which was a drive to collect donated comfort materials for veterans of the Veterans Affairs Hospitals and Seaports, Lions, and Pratt, New Jersey, as well as local veterans who needed them. And whereas Leo is a 2014 graduate of Weehawken High School, who served as student council president, played drums for Weehawken High School band, and had leading character roles in the high school musicals, and used to make my daughter crazy while high school was in my head. And whereas at 17 years of age, Leo enlisted in the U.S. Army National Guard and currently holds the rank of private first class as a military police officer with the 508th Military Police Company, and presently just finished his freshman year at Montclair University. To take what?
I was a Justice Studies major.
You were a Justice Studies major, I think, when we had your February 17th event, or whatever event was. You switched that fast?
I don't attend Montclair anymore.
Oh, you don't? Okay. We'll go on to that later. Okay. And whereas the Township of Weehawken is always proud to recognize the outstanding public and private achievements of their fellow residents, and in this instance, Leo Hochhauser. Now, therefore, be resolved by Richard Turner, Mayor of the Township of Weehawken, on behalf of the Township Council and citizens of Weehawken, to hereby commend Leo Hochhauser for his dedication to Lord's services and for his many contributions to our community and to the accord. So, you're very short for words. Come on up. Now, you gotta tell me, you gotta listen to me, or you're really up to that.
Well, you missed when I was mayor for a day.
I know, that's true. I didn't put that in there. Because when he was mayor for a day, he said he wanted to come back and do it permanently. You know why? He's taking some time off from Montclair. Does mom and dad know what he wants to do? He's going to be a dispatcher in the police department.
That's legal. Yeah.
So, we're working out. Okay, so anyway, that's my favorite. We're going to have ethics with council, the council on the board and forward. All right, we have two individuals here that want to address us, so before we do the meeting, you know, why don't you come up and give your name and address and then bring forth what you want to talk about.
Sure, perfect. You can get a close up. I'm Louis Elrock, I'm with Entertainment Cruises. You guys know what's probably the one Spirit Cruises, and most likely Spirit of the which is where we've been kind of beyond for a very long time. We've been supportive in terms of the great students who saved us in December, every other year when we can, we skip 2013, and maybe we can enjoy that once the us. By the way, congratulations on Peter that you put on there. I personally have been there and taken a lot of pictures, and I think it's the best for you. It's exciting to me, being in London with this, and now we have that here. And I want to introduce my colleague, this is Mario Fadua. And Mario Fadua also works with some of the students and schools in New Jersey. So the reason why we're approaching you today is to be considered for any kind of events that may be happening in the schools. I know there's a new superintendent that's starting soon, so I think it's a good time. Anything that we consider, what I mean by that, it could be a junior prom, it could be a high school prom, or project graduation. Obviously, people make their own decisions, they have a classroom make their own decision. Being a student from class of 1988, we want to know how it works.
What year?
1988. How many people are in 1988? So besides my own class reunion that's coming up in a couple of years, I was in between nurses.
30 years?
30 years is coming up, yes. I was in between Janitor. So we just want to be considered.
And we have all your contact information for us.
You should have it. I want some additional sales kit. The students may be able to general manager also ask me to tell you anything going on in terms of career for the future in Weehawken.
With all the construction down there, it's working out okay? It's a little convenient, but...
It's a little convenient. We are relaying that message.
Yeah, they're going to put your maps in order to go.
Right, now it's the floating dot for them to get to our boats or some of the private charters. But we're dealing with it as okay. Best as possible.
Right, okay.
So just be considered for anything.
Okay.
So we'll be making some kind of emails to adjust not only
the
classes.
We'll forward everything to the president.
Perfect. Thank if there's anything for us to follow up on, just let me know.
Very good. Thank you. Nice meeting you. Good seeing you again. Hello,
Mom. Nice to see you, Mr. Perry, again. It was a pleasure seeing you. I'm sure I'll see you at some point.
Okay, perfect. Thank you.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Have a good night.
Have a good night.
Okay. Hearing adoption of orders number 3-2016, do you have a plan? Okay, what's that?
Do
you want to say something now?
Yes.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Whatever to me.
Whatever you want.
So I just have, please forgive me if this is something I should know but I don't. So I noticed today you're doing, there's unfinished business of ordinance 3-2016 development.
Right.
I don't know what that is.
Okay, we're going to have a hearing and then right now I'm hearing that, so stay right there.
Well, I was going to ask one question. Is there a way to see the ordinances before they?
Sure, what you have to do, they're all published, what you do is about that.
Okay, so we just, when do we know something's being published?
Well, if it's in the paper, it's published, there's no other way to do it. We have to publish it.
We have
the
reporter,
Jersey Journal, CNN, and then the agenda's on the website, so you see it on the agenda.
I did that. Okay.
It's on the town website, and it's in the paper. So if you look at the town website, it's probably easier.
Okay, yeah.
But you never know, from time to time, it works. It's not like every meeting is
right,
working.
Right, exactly.
Just stay right there and you can ask your question. Do I have a motion for hearing adoption of ordinance number 3-2016 redevelopment plan?
So moved. Second.
Moves Councilman Spezier, second Councilman Zucconi. We will now open public hearing discussion on ordinance number 3-2016, which is a redevelopment plan. Now, you may ask your question.
What is it?
What it is we have now the Parks Mountain property, which is the Walmart area. Under very old zoning. It was adopted in 1984. And that's when the area was going to be much more commercial than it is now. Industrial office and commercial jobs here to UBS buildings. And there was supposed to be two more of those buildings. And they're very large buildings. So over the years, it switched to residential. Well, I think all, basically all the park area is done. We have, you know, 40% of the roads of the property is park, and I think about 37% roughly of the arch property is park. So I don't think we'll get some more plazas. We probably have most open space of any community in Hudson County overall now. So, you know, that basically is set. What we want to do is develop some more, but maybe we'll get some more to develop. But instead of, you know, we have 5 acres that's fallow next to the 10-acre park. So we want to see, report that from Arch Mountain about 15 years ago, 3 acres grant. So the next goal is to develop that in some form of recreational complex. So if you take the 10 acres we have, if we're successful doing that, 5 acres, and then we have about 2 acres across the little lagoon by Bowman Avenue.
Yeah.
We'll have 17 acres, will be the biggest area of open space, passive and recreation, other than the State Park and the whole river. Mm-hmm. So we have quite a lot. And Hawks will do some more odds and ends, but it won't be anything as big as the 10 acres. Actually, you know, that 15 acres is both developed by Hawks and by Roseland.
And
the 2 acres on the other side of the room was from Marks.
Right.
And the door right on the other side of Waterfront Terrace is also my home.
And we're not going to lose the Weehawken present parking down there for the
light. No. There might be a garage from there. It'll be a little more convenient. But no, it's 100 spaces. I think it's 100 spaces. 800 spaces. And it'll be surface. Okay. Anyone else have a comment on ordinance number 3-2016? Please come forward. Motion to close and adopt.
Yes, we can move to close and adopt.
Second.
Move by Sylvester Sheriff, Senator Zuccone, roll call, Madam Clerk.
Councilwoman Sylvester Eric?
Yes.
Councilman Alpino?
Yes.
Councilman Zuccone?
Yes.
Mayor Federer?
Yes. The ordinance is adopted. And we have a resolution to reappoint a member of the Park Authority. Elazar Nunez for a 5-year term beginning 2027, ending 2027-2021. Do I have a motion?
Second.
Moved by Councilwoman Lavadino, second by Councilman Zuccone, roll call, Madam Clerk.
Councilwoman Sebastiani?
Yes.
Councilman Lavadino?
Yes.
Councilman Zuccone?
Yes.
Mayor yes. Resolution for our Safe and Secure grant, $60,000 annual grant from the state of New Jersey. Do I have a motion?
Second.
Lavadino, second to Zuccone, roll call.
Councilman Sebastiani?
Yes.
Councilman Lavadino?
Yes.
Councilman Zuccone?
Yes.
Mayor Federer?
Then we have a resolution for overpayment of taxes. Mm-hmm. And to refund of $23.64. Move by Councilman Sebastiani.
Second.
Councilman Zuccone, roll call.
Councilman Sebastiani?
Yes.
Councilman Lavadino?
Yes.
Councilman Zuccone?
Yes.
Mayor Federer? Very good project. This is going to be authorized a clinical study for 49.
purchase the building, develop the one to subdivide the interior, make it condominiums, and the township for a long time was trying to purchase the building to preserve it as a beautiful historic building built in 1928. I mean, been up there and saw the trust company building. It's a beautiful building, very large. So we've had envision for many, many years is utilizing that building as kind of a festival marketplace to bring more activity to that section of Park Avenue. As we all know, we have a large artist community, and they, you know, they have no showcase areas where they can't afford to rent regular space. The rents on Park Avenue are very high. It's amazing. They average from $2,500 to $3,500 a month. And a lot of our local artists and boutique operators can't afford that, so we thought we would provide that. It's 10,000 square feet inside that building. Also maybe some food shops, some sandwich shops, coffee shop, or whatever. So as we were going to purchase it, the Capital One had two other locations, and they wanted to sell all three simultaneously. So obviously we can't, we weren't going to buy a property in another town, so we couldn't purchase it, and the individual bought it. Like I said, wanted to subdivide the interior, make condominiums, so we had a long discussion, and we have a tentative agreement that we will lease the downstairs. We're looking at a 30-year lease. We went before the board just last night as an alternative. We got approval to build 60 apartment units or condominiums yet to be determined on top of the building. So the building will be preserved. We'll get 60 apartments or condominium buildings on top of the building. Same height, no higher than the senior citizen building, which we just opened up across the street. And it will preserve the trust company building. And the goal we've had for many years is to bring various new activities to Park Avenue. So we think that'll work out. And I have to say, the transformation of the third ward, which is basically from Clifton, Columbia, north over the last few years, has been tremendous. The Elks was rebuilt, the American Legion was rebuilt with state funds, and we built a new park in front of it. The park we're going with the excellent is on 50th, the corner of 50th and Park. An old factory building that is vacant for years and years and years is now about to be opened up as a condominium site or an apartment site. The old bridge buildings that were vacant for years, 49th and 50th, and now thriving businesses in such 3 or 4 years. A new senior building, which replaced the horrible slash Park Avenue Hotel, opened up this month. The last boarding flop house on 46th Street was closed on some years ago, based on our efforts, and we were able to have someone come in and build 14 condominiums on 46th Street. So the revitalization of that section of town is nearly complete. It's moving forward very fast. And this building is so beautiful, we decided not to lose it, and we've accomplished our goal. And we took the benefit of the entire community. Having said that, we have to authorize a revitalization plan for the building, which allows us to open up federal and state grants, maybe tax dollars, tax credit dollars from some agencies in order to rehab this building now. And we'll be setting up committee of people who know how to do this stuff, because obviously it wasn't good. So I'd like Resolution F to be authorizing the planning board to study the
Devon?
Yes.
Councilman Lovey?
Yes.
Councilman Zapolyn?
Yes.
Mayor Trentrum?
Yes. All right, approve of bills to be paid. We have paid the stuff, we have paid the bills. It's on, I get the security for the power processing. Do you have an addendum report, as the council knows, we are closing part of
372.
372, part of the building department, rec offices, and the community development office, and we're leasing property in the Tower Plaza Mall for council members to negotiate a great deal. And that building has to be rehabbed because of tremendous water infiltration that has created problems over there. So what we will do with that whole site, what we'll determine in the next several months as we go forward, but the top of that building will be vacated. So the rec office temporarily, all the planning office, the planning office from 372, and the community development office, we relocate up to Tower Plaza Mall. So, and that's why you have an addendum on your bills, because we have a down payment on the security deposit. All right, do you have a motion for the bills?
And I'll second.
Lobby made the motion, Sylvester, second, for the bills, please.
Councilman Sylvester Devon?
Yes.
Councilman Lovey?
Yes.
Councilman Zapolyn?
Yes.
Mayor Trentrum?
Now, we have two items for executive session. One is potential litigation. One is litigation, one is potential litigation. So we're going to go on executive session. We'll have a pause on the floor. Any credit for the council on the matter? Go ahead.
One more thing. I just wanted to first congratulate you on the exceeding residence housing policy. I thought that was really great.
Nice.
Yeah, it's really, it's good to see more affordable housing for folks, and just wanted to congratulate you on that.
And equally important, if I may add, it was the building that was there, the old flophouse, was such a bad operation.
Yeah.
And it had so many problems, obviously, from robbers all the way up to the worst thing that could happen.
It was like the murders.
A murder, yeah. But the burglars just operated out of there. It was just horrible. So it was a seven-year struggle. It takes a long time to condemn the property. You have to go to court, you have to come up with the money to take care of it, then you have to get the funding. Then they found the rock, and it was all contaminated materials in the building and everything, so. But it's a beautiful building, and if anybody wants to go by, they should go in and look in the lobby. It's a beautiful building. 28 units, and these are people who are, that really needed decent housing, so it's a very nice thing. One of the really nice things we can accomplish, being in office, so.
That was really great to see.
And the housing authority, and the senior citizen rehab corporation, and, you know, the executive director was Dr. Chini, the economy assessors, chairman of the board, and they worked endlessly. You know, you don't know if you're gonna get the money, you don't know if you're not gonna get the money, you don't meet the deadline. The original contractor went bankrupt. They had to go with the bond company. The bond company's contractor went bankrupt, and, you know, it was just one nightmare after another. It's a beautiful building, it's all worth the effort.
And why that you've been preserving the buildings, why you have them?
It's a beautiful building. It's just a gorgeous building, and you can't replace it.
My only concern is hearing all these condos go up. I'm worried about parking. It's already parking is sort of a nightmare. Is there any plans as, you know, more developers to get more parking?
Almost all the condos have to provide parking, so they all park on the first floor. For instance, the building on 50th and Park, that originally had a garage in it, a one-floor garage. I don't know what they did with it years ago, but they had a one-floor garage there, and they retained that. The building for the 6 years is a garage underneath. The only thing we had to do was grant a small parking variance for the old bank. There wasn't enough land, so we're trying to work arrangements with other areas to allow them to have some. They were able to meet half of their obligation, I think, and the other half they couldn't. But the board just felt that it was worth giving up some parking spaces to save the building. But almost everybody else has to put parking. The buildings on Hackensack Lane Road, the new building, has a garage underneath, you know, so they all have